Today we're going to be talking about basic maintenance on the Machete 2 boom mower. What we have here today is a Machete 2 25-foot boom mower, and we're going to go through the steps required to do the basic maintenance that we need to do on the mower. The first part I'm going to look at is under the hood, of the front hood of the tractor. So we're going to open this up. We find underneath the pumps, as well as the filters and the control valve. First thing we need to look at is, this is the charge pump filter that filters the oil that goes through the charge system in the pump. We need to make sure it doesn't need to be changed. Check the dates. Also, the return filter. This is return oil coming back into the tank. It has a canister filter and should be changed per the schedule in the operator's manual. Check all the hoses and connections. Make sure there's no leaks. You can tell if there's dirt or oil on the tank or on the hoses. Make sure they're tight. Check the valve fittings and connections. Make sure there's no leaks there. Also check your electrical connections. Make sure they're tight. Just a Phillips screwdriver. Finally, you want to check the oil level in the tank. Make sure that it is at least 3/4 full. As you see, this one's a little bit low. We need to add some oil. Make sure you fill it with the proper oil per the decal on the side. Finally, we want to check the bolts that mount the pump to the front of the tractor, as well as the bolts that mount the pump mount plate to the front of the tractor. Also, the drive shaft needs to be checked. There's bolts that connect it to the pump. We need to make sure they're tight. And then the drive shaft should be lubricated. There's a grease joint in the front here, as well as back near the tractor and on the sliding member of the drive shaft. All those grease fittings need to be lubricated. After we've completed our basic maintenance under the hood, we can move to the side of the tractor. We're on the boom side of the tractor to start with. First thing we want to check is we want to make sure we have a torque wrench. Look in the operator's manual for the torque chart that tells you the specifications for tightening the bolts. And check the bolts that mount the frame to the tractor. You also want to check the bolts that mount the mounting rail to the mount structure. And finally, the mounting bolts that mount the frame itself to the rail. You want to check all those bolts and make sure they're properly torqued. And we want to also look at the hoses and make sure they're retained properly. In other words, they're tied against the tractor so they don't get in the way of the tire or other debris. They're not damaged due to hitting branches or things. And they have this cover on them to protect them. You want to check the fittings here and make sure there's no leaks out to the motor. You want to check the fittings at the cylinders, lift cylinder and the swing cylinder. And then check your connections for the hoses up here where they attach to the boom. We want to also lubricate the boom in this area. We have to lubricate the swing cylinder on both ends. Then we need to lubricate the kingpin. The bearings down here, there's a grease fitting here on the bottom and a grease fitting on the top. Also, there's a grease fitting here to lubricate the boom main pin. That's where it's attached to the king post. Once we're finished with the king post and that side of the tractor, we need to move on and do a maintenance inspection on the boom itself. We want to make sure that these guards on this side of the boom are in good shape and in place, because they protect the hoses inside here from trees hitting it. So make sure the guards are tight, the bolts are in good condition. Also, we want to do an overall inspection of the boom assembly itself. What we want to look for is any damage or cracking that may be occurring, and we need to correct that as soon as we can. Also, you want to check the pins at the pivot points and make sure there's not excess play in the pin, which would indicate a worn out bearing, but you need to replace the bearing. You want to check the hoses again and the covering on the hoses as well to make sure they're in good shape. Make sure there's no leaks and the fittings are tight. Check the cylinder hoses as well. Some go down inside the boom. Make sure those are in good condition, that the protective sleeve is on them and they're in good shape, not leaking. Once we've done all that, we want to make sure we lubricate. So we start with the lift cylinder on the rod end. And if you notice, I have this boom extended out so I can reach the dipper cylinder up here. You may need to get a step ladder. lubricate the base end of the dipper cylinder and the rod end of the dipper cylinder. Also, very important, we want to make sure we lubricate the dipper pivot pin here. Okay, after we've inspected the boom, we move down closer to the head and to the head itself. At the end of the boom, we have the head tilt cylinder. We need to make sure the guard's in place. It's protecting the cylinder. Make sure the pin is tight. We also want to check the head tilt pivot pin. Make sure it's in good shape, that the castle nut is tight, and that we make sure we lubricate this pin as well. There's also grease fittings here on this swivel and on this one as well. Want to check again the hydraulic hoses. Make sure the cover is in place. There's no leaks that we can see. Make sure everything's tight. On the head itself, we have the head swivel cylinder and the door cylinder. We want to make sure that the bolt attaching the swivel cylinder is tight, that it's not coming loose, and that the structure is in good shape. You want to check for any cracks. You also want to check the rod end as well. Make sure it's in good shape. Same with the head, the door cylinder. You want to check that the pins are in good shape and that the rod's not bent and there's no leaks or anything. Check the hoses as well. Very important on the cutting head is to check the mounting bolts that attach the motor to the spindle. It's very important that these bolts are checked every day. Make sure they're tight. Also in the spindle, there is a vent and then a filler greaser. We need to make sure the vent is clear and that the cylinder is full of grease. Then check your hydraulic fittings here on the motor. Make sure they're not leaking, and the case drain down below as well. Check the structure of the head itself. Make sure it's not cracking, or make sure there's no damage from impacts or anything like that. And finally, on the head, we also want to make sure that our deflectors are in good shape. They're not torn, bent, or missing. If they are, we need to get them replaced. There's a front deflector and a rear deflector. Then we're going to move to the underside of the head. But before we do that, we need to check and make sure that the bearing on the swivel is greased properly. There are actually three grease certs around the perimeter of the bearing, and we need to make sure they have enough grease in them. Now we move to the underside of the mower. We want to check everything under here. First thing before you want to do this is to make sure you have the keys to the tractor in your hand. You don't want anybody starting the tractor while you're working on the rotating parts. What we look at under the mower is the blade assembly. The blades, most important part of the mower, they get all the abuse. What we look for on blades is damage, cuts and gouges that could cause cracking that you can't really see inside the blade itself, which could lead to a failure of the blade. If you have any gouging or cracks on these blades, they need to be replaced. They are reversible, but it does no good to reverse them if they're already in danger of being broken. When you do replace the blades, you need to replace them in the set. These come from Alamo Industrial in a match set. We weigh them so that they are balanced. If you put a worn out blade or a lighter blade with a heavier blade, it's going to cause vibration, which will lead to more damage to your mower. Also, when you replace the blade, you want to replace the blade bolts as well. The blade bolts have a castellated nut with a roll pin, and all those components should be replaced when you replace the blades. You torque the blade bolts to 400 foot-pounds. The blades are mounted to the cutter bar. The cutter bar is made up of three leaves, which are bolted together. We need to check the blade bar for excessive wear. Some wear, rounding off, is normal, but if you have excessive wear or if you see some cracking from the bolt holes that retain the leaves together, you need to replace the blade bar. It is not rebuildable. The leaves are actually bolted together with these large bolts and torqued to 2,000 foot-pounds. So we can torque these for you at the factory, but they shouldn't be serviced in the field. The blade bar is mounted to the spindle with these mounting bolts, which are also torqued to 400 foot-pounds. You need to check the torque on these bolts and make sure they're tight. Need to check the guard on top of the blade bar. The guard protects the spindle bearing from damage. If you get a fence wrapped in the spindle, it keeps the wire out of the spindle bearing. So check the guard, make sure it's in good shape. Make sure there's nothing wrapped around the spindle. Check the bolts that hold the spindle to the deck and make sure they're tight per the torque chart in the operator's manual. Then we want to also check the skid shoes on the mower deck. This is a normal wear item. They will wear. We need to make sure they're not wearing into the structure of the deck itself and replace these skid shoes as needed. Then we also want to check the structure. We want to check for any cracking on the deck surface. We want to make sure that the deflector guards are in place, not broken off, and generally look over the mower itself. On the left side of the tractor, just like on the right-hand side, we need to make sure that the bolts that mount the frame and the structure to the tractor are tight per the bolt torque chart that's in the operator's manual. So check these bolts that mount the rail mounting to the tractor. Check the rail mounting bolts, make sure they're tight, as well as the frame mounting bolts. There's some here, then the clamps, the mounting bolts back here, and the bolt that holds the counterweight up. Check the wheel weight. Make sure it's tight by torquing the bolts with a torque wrench. Make sure they're tight per the torque chart in the operator's manual. At the back of the tractor, the frame structure mounts to the rear axle of the tractor. It's important to check the bolts underneath that hold the rails to the bottom of the rear axle on both sides. In addition, we need to check these clamps that clamp the structure to the rear axle and make sure those bolts are tight as well. The last thing we want to check is we want to make sure that the boom rest is positioned properly to prevent damage to the cab. The way we do that is to carefully put the boom into the boom rest, watching to make sure that it doesn't contact the cab. So we want to make sure that the boom doesn't swing and hit the cab. The way we do that is with the stop, the swing stop on the king post. And also, we can adjust this plate out and up with these bolts and then torque them properly per the torque chart in the operator's manual. This concludes our overview of the basic maintenance required on the Machete 2 boom mower. If you have any questions, you can always refer to your operator's manual, and you can always call your customer service accounts representative at Alamo Industrial. Appreciate you watching. Thank you.